Hi guys, my name's James and this is Billy, and we're here to introduce the X550 and the Z901 CSI OneBox. We're going to be talking about these two technologies today and how they complement each other and how you use these two technologies in the field to be able to analyze any of your material, whether you're sorting or grading material. These two instruments will complement each other in completing that analysis. We'll be looking at different stainless steels. You'll be able to do low alloy steels, and then you'll be able to grade those materials based on the carbon content afterwards. Typically, your X550 or your XRF is used as a workhorse instrument. It's the instrument that you do all of your identification with. You're looking at your major elements with it. And then on those occasions that you do need to grade that material, whether it's L or H grade, you're able to use the CSI, and we're going to demonstrate that today. Typically in the field, you'll be using your instrument to sort material. And the difference in that is looking at 304 or 316 or some kind of stainless steel material, or sorting any of your low alloy materials or your high nickel materials. This instrument's capable of doing that, and it's basically a point and shoot instrument, and it's called XRF technology. Basically, you take the instrument, you apply it to the material that you want to shoot, and you pull the trigger for just a few seconds. And then as soon as you're done with that, you got a complete analysis of the instrument. And then you're able to identify that material based on that analysis. It also gives you the name of that material at the top of the screen. And then if you got to shoot another piece, you just basically do the same thing. You put it on that, and now we have sorted the difference between a piece of 316 and a piece of 304. Now, when we get into the grading of that material, whether it's L or H, we have to use a different technology. XRF's not capable of identifying carbon, so we go to a LIBS instrument. And Billy's gonna basically do the same thing. There's a few more steps involved when you're using the CSI or a LIBS instrument. And with that, you'll have to prep the material, which we've done ahead of time. But once you wanna know that grade, whether it's L or H grade, you're then able to do the same thing. You present the material to the nose of the analyzer, you pull the trigger, and then you read out the carbon content based on that analysis. So Billy's doing the same thing here. As you can see, this is gonna be a little bit longer shot. It's taking a laser and it's pulsing that laser. And as it pulses that laser, it gives you a few intermediate shots that we use to create an average. After we have that average, we hit save on the analyzer, and then it gives you a full carbon readout. By utilizing that carbon readout, you're able to grade whether that material's L or H grade. And in this case, we were shooting a piece of 316, and that needs to be less than 0.03 carbon. So now we couple that with our merging software that we have that you'll see in a later video on the 316 essential elements, which in this case will be nickel, chrome, and moly, coupled with the carbon analysis that we just got of less than 0.03 to get a 316L reading. So now basically what you've done is you just used two complementary technologies to be able to grade that material in the field.